Why aren't the Imams alayhum as-salam specifically mentioned by name in the Holy Quran? And this is a very important question. To be honest, we have to mention several points. The first one is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the Quran doesn't mention lots of names. As an example, Allah azza wa jal spoke about several companions in the Quran. He spoke about many hypocrites, many good believers, many disbelievers, but he did not name them. He mentioned them by description. The only companion mentioned in the Quran by name was Zayd ibn Haritha, may Allah bless his soul. As Allah says in Surah Al-Ahzab, فَلَمَّا قَضَى زَيْدٌ مِنْهَا وَطَرَى. He mentioned Zayd. Whereas we realize that the Quran usually does not mention names, even when it comes to Pharaoh. Pharaoh is a title, not a name. So the Quran doesn't mention names a lot. It leaves it upon Rasulullah and the Imams alayhim as-salatu was-salam to explain the verses of the Quran and to tell us who is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala exactly speaking about. Number two, Imam al-Sadiq alayhi as-salatu was-salam was asked this question. He was asked, and if you look into Al-Kafi, Kitab Al-Kafi, you will see a narration by the Imam. As he's asked, why weren't the Imams mentioned by name? Why doesn't the Quran say, for example, that your guardians are Allah, Rasulullah, and Ali ibn Abi Talib, alayhi salam? The Imam says that the Quran would bring down general messages upon Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi. In other terms, general messages would be mentioned in the verses of God. For example, Allah says, أَقِيمُ الصَّلَاةِ. Then He leaves it upon Rasulullah to explain how should we pray. How many rik'ahs does Allah want us to pray? Two, three, or four? Where should we direct ourselves in salat? What should we do? What are the invalidators of salat? This was left upon the shoulders of Rasulullah. Allah said to fast in the Quran. But Rasulullah came forth and explained what are the invalidators of fasting, what are the kaffarat, and other details. Allah said, وَلِلَّهِ عَلَى النَّاسِ حِجُّ الْبَيْتِ مَنْ اسْتَطَاعَ إِلَيْهِ سَبِيلًا, telling us that it is an obligation to perform pilgrimage when you're able. Who explained what you should do in Hajj? Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi. Allah said, آتُ الزَّكَاةِ, pay alms, pay charity. Who explained the percentage of what should be paid? And what should zakat be paid on? None other than Rasulullah. So Imam al-Sadiq says, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned imamate generally in the Quran and then left it upon Rasulullah to explain who were the imams. One could ask, where has Allah mentioned imamate? Where has Allah mentioned the imams alayhim as-salatu was-salam? Allah says, for example, أَطِيعُ اللَّهِ وَأَطِيعُ الرَّسُولِ وَأُولِي الْأَمْرِ مِنْكُمْ. Who are these ulul amr? Obey Allah and obey the messenger and those who have authority amongst you. Jabir ibn Abdullah al-Ansari questioned Rasulullah, saying, O messenger of Allah, we have known Allah and we know who is the messenger. But who are these ulul amr that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has commanded us to obey? What did the Prophet say? He said, هُمْ خُلَفَاءِ يَا جَابِرِ. They are my caliphs, and they are the imams amongst my ummah. They are, the first one amongst them is Ali ibn Abi Talib, then Hassan, then Hussein, then Ali son of Hussein, then Muhammad son of Ali, who is mentioned in the Tawrat as Al-Baqir, meaning the one who splits open the gates of knowledge, and you will meet him, O Jabir. So convey him my salam. Then Ja'far son of Muhammad, then Musa son of Ja'far, then Ali son of Musa, then Muhammad son of Ali, then Ali son of Muhammad, then Hassan son of Ali, then Samiyyi, the one who holds my name, meaning Muhammad. Wakaniyyi, the one who holds my kunya, Abu al-Qasim. And then he mentioned Sahib al-Zaman and his ghaibah, his occultation. May Allah hasten his reappearance. And so Allah Ta'ala mentioned imamate, but he left it upon Rasulullah to mention the details. Who were the imams, alayhim as-salatu was-salam, exactly? Thirdly, the third point is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala If he were to mention the names of the Imams alayhim as-salam explicitly in the verses of the Quran, we would have fallen into a big trap. What is that trap? You see, if Allah said in Ayatul Wilaya, verse 55 of chapter 5, if Allah said, إِنَّمَا وَلِيُّكُمُ اللَّهُ وَرَسُولُهُ وَعَلِيُّ بْنُ أَبِي طَالِبٍ, if Allah said it in that way, do you know what the enemies of Ahlul Bayt would have done? And I hope you're paying close attention, because this is a very important point. Sallallahu ala Muhammad wa ali Muhammad. The enemies of Ahlul Bayt would have created thousands of Ali ibn Abi Talibs and would have said which Ali ibn Abi Talib was actually meant in the verse. By all means, Muawiyah would have called himself Ali ibn Abi Talib to say, Allah is talking about me. But Allah Azza wa Jal, mentioned Imam Ali through his description. As he said, those who believe, those who uphold the prayer, pay sadaqah, they pay zakat, they pay charity as they're in the state of ruku'ah. Muawiyah and the likes of Muawiyah could not claim to be that person, because the whole ummah, the nation knew who did that act, who was actually mentioned by Allah. And so Allah mentions Ahlul Bayt, but he mentions them through their traits. And thus you see that Sunni and Shia scholars alike, say, when they comment upon the verses of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that multiple verses mentioned Ahlul Bayt. One Sunni scholar, named his book 500 verses that talk about Ali ibn Abi Talib alayhi salat wa salam. The fourth point is that if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned their names explicitly, Allah has promised to preserve the book of God, has promised to preserve his verses. It's possible that the verses of Allah would have been altered. وَالْعِيَاذُ بِاللَّهِ. And so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to preserve the verses, did not mention the names explicitly. Fifthly, the names of the Ahlul Bayt were mentioned in the explanations of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. As you may know, Rasulullah would explain the verses of the Quran to the Muslims. He wouldn't only tell them what the verse says, he would add explanations from himself, sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. And in those explanations, their names were mentioned. And I'll give you an example. If you look into the book Ad-Durr al-Manthur by Shaykh al-Sayuti, you will see that he says, قال ابن مردوي قال أخرج ابن مردوي عن ابن مسعود قال كنا نقرأ على عهد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم يا أيها الرسول بلغ ما أنزل إليك من ربك أن عليا مولى المؤمنين وأن لم تفعل فما بلغت رسالته. Ibn Mas'ud says, in Durr al-Manthur is a Sunni tafsir, Ibn Mas'ud says, we used to recite this verse saying, O Messenger of Allah, deliver the message of your Lord concerning who? Concerning Ali, that Ali is the master of the believers. And if you do not do so, then you have not delivered his message. And so the names were mentioned in the explanations of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wasallam. The last and final point is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if we look carefully in the Quran, he did mention the name of Ali at least once, even in the verse of the Quran. But the verse isn't really, not many people pay attention towards this verse. As he says in verse 50, Surah Maryam, وَجَعَلْنَا لَهُمْ لِسَانَ صِدْقٍ عَلِيًّا. So the blessed name of Ali was mentioned in the verse. And Allah mentioned Ahlul Bayt collectively. As he said, إِنَّمَا يُرِيدُ اللَّهُ لِيُذْهِبَ عَنْكُمُ الرِّجْسَ. Ahlul Bayt, he mentioned them. صَلَوَاتُ اللَّهِ وَسَلَامُهُ عَلَيْهِمْ.